the pause of making a point the second time.
Right.
Let's see. There we go. Okay. Now back to it.
Yep.
Still yet, if someone came up and told me, somewhat go back to what I was just saying before all this. If someone came up to me and said, let's build a statue of Baker Mayfield right now.
Okay.
I would laugh at him
and, what would you
and call him stupid. I would give it to LeBron. I would give it to Jim Brown. Give it to so many other people. I would give Jim Thome one.
Oh, he already has one.
I know. Still yet, give them one before I would give it to Baker. He hasn't proven squat.
Well, he's proven he could be a rookie and look like a veteran.
Not completely. Let's go back to Houston, man.
Okay, that's one game.
No, but you said he looked like a veteran.
Yeah, because you know what?
He didn't look like a veteran. But you know what? He looked like a mediocre high school QB.
Wait a second. So wait a minute. You're telling me that a guy who comes off of a loss like that and rebounds and beats a playoff contender by 6 points is not proving anything? Come on now. Are you serious? You're telling me that, Baker Mayfield, yeah, he had a bad start against Houston. And then he comes back and has a fantastic start against Carolina. But you're telling me that, he's still, Baker slow start Mayfield. Come on. Jeremiah, there's something.
He doesn't look like a veteran.
Oh, okay. You're missing something. Cause
look at Pittsburgh. He looked pretty rookie. He didn't look like a veteran. How many picks did he have?
Against two.
Exactly. How much did the offense score? Nothing, really.
Against who?
Pittsburgh.
Okay, but
they're still a playoff contender.
No, they're not. They're out of the playoffs. Are you kidding? They're out.
No. Pittsburgh?
Yeah, they're out. They're out of the playoff picture, I think. Last I checked.
I don't know about that, sir. We'll go and look that up right this second.
Take a look.
While you're tripping over chairs and all the other things. Look at this. Right here. Pittsburgh.
Okay.
7-5-1. They're still in the playoff picture.
And so are the Browns at 5-7-1.
See, look right there. They're number four. You were just saying that they were knocked out of the playoffs.
I thought they were, personally. I thought they were.
Where have you been? The moon?
Who knows?
Yeah, they're leading the division, then Baltimore closely right behind them. But still yet, he looked not like a veteran for sure against Pittsburgh. He looked very mediocre.
Right. Hey, question, is that commercial uploaded yet? What? I'm just laughing.
No, I'm not even going into that this second.
Okay. I'm just checking the time.
Yeah, I have whatever the stuff here.
Perfect.
Haven't really uploaded the thing, but I'll get to that.
Okay.
But the thing is,
yes.
You make the thing of he looked horrible versus Pittsburgh. But he looked good versus, and that Pittsburgh's still a playoff team. You can't argue that he
They're
looked
not
like a
be,
veteran.
Here's the thing is that if Pittsburgh, reminder for you guys, if Pittsburgh loses or the rest, if they keep losing like they are right now, they lost to the Raiders, the Oakland Raiders. Come on.
Come on. If you have Connor in there, that they would be rolling
over. Connor wasn't in. But you're telling me
hurt.
Wait. But you're telling me that they're a playoff team when they lose to the Oakland Raiders. Yeah, you heard me. The Oakland Raiders. You're telling me they're still a playoff team? A team that loses to the Oakland Raiders is not a playoff team, in my opinion. The Oakland Raiders are a mediocre team. The Steelers are a above average
team.
We're
mediocre.
No, we're not.
Yeah, we are.
We're getting out of that mediocre shell. We are.
Are we in the playoffs this second?
We're going to be.
No, we're not in the playoffs this second.
Okay.
We're not the top six teams.
I say you're pulling a little Stephen A. Smith on me or something?
Well, that's the thing is, you're sitting here and saying yes. Well, possibly. No, possibly. Right now, our record, are we in the playoffs?
No, but we will be. We will be.
I don't see that even happening.
Mark my words, people.
But no, it's simple. Are we in the playoffs?
No, but we're going to be.
Why do you keep on saying we're going to be? No, right now. We're not. 6-6 teams are going to playoffs this second.
We're not going to be in the playoffs.
Exactly.
But there's that chance. There's that slim chance.
No, I'm saying right now.
Oh, right now? No, we're not in the playoff picture. We're in the hunt. We're basically...
Exactly.
Is it
the Panthers?
Yes, they're in the hunt.
No, they're not in the playoffs either.
No.
If it's right now, 6-6 teams right now going at it.
Uh-huh.
Panthers aren't. We aren't. Uh-huh. Pittsburgh is.
They're a wild card.
No. They're number four.
They're in the wild card.
Baltimore's wild.
Look up the playoff picture on CBSSports.com and it will show the matchups. It would be Houston and Pittsburgh in the wild card game. Mark my word. I'm being serious about that. I looked it up. Not on ESPN, it'd be on CBS Sports. That's where I found it.
Oh my God.
What's with the, I don't know, it's just an ad.
Let's see, Pittsburgh. Da, 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 da. They're not a wild card.
Who?
Wait, who?
Pittsburgh.
Yeah, they are.
No, they're a top seed. Baltimore's a wild card. These two got byes, and it's two teams that are in the playoff picture that played the two
games. I thought those were the wild card matchups. I swear to you, I thought those were.
Where are you at, man?
I don't know. Play that drum. I'm stupid. Say, that's the definition of me. I'm stupid. I have no idea where I've been, but.
Yeah. Kansas City, New England, they're going to have a bye the first round. The two teams underneath them played the two wild card teams.
True.
They're playing in the wild card. The only thing is they're not the actual wild card. Baltimore is.
Right.
Because they're the low seed. So, yes.
I'll say, before we continue, a reminder, the sports show is brought to you by Play It Again Sports in Lyndhurst, the number one sporting goods store to go to for new and used sporting goods at the cheapest prices. Play It Again Sports in Lyndhurst at 5455 Mayfield Road in Lyndhurst, Ohio, or call them at 440-461-8474. Shout out to those guys, Matt and Ned out at Play It Again Sports in Lyndhurst. I know you guys probably watching right now. Shout out to you guys. You guys are the best. So, but hey, let's get back to the Browns talk. I mean, now I want to ask you this question. Jeremiah, I know you said, oh, they're not going to build a statue, this and that. I know they're not going to do that. I mean, we all know it. But let me ask you this question. If the Browns, and I'm saying this is a big if the Browns were to make the playoffs as at 8-7-1, if they were to win their next three games and finish 8-7-1, if they were to make the playoffs and the Browns make this magical, you know, Cinderella story type run and get to the AFC Championship or even the Super Bowl for all I know, would you consider building a statue for Baker Mayfield?
No.
Now, what if they win the Super Bowl? Let's say they make a magic run and they win the Super Bowl at 8-7-1. Still no?
No.
You must be smoking something. I'm sorry. I would build a statue for sure. If he took a team that was nothing and turned them into something in one year, I would say build him a statue. Period. That's it. Because there's no other guy in the NFL that is like that, where they take a team that is nothing and turn them into something in one year.
We can go back to Philly. We can go back to their thing of, you know, Wisen Hunt or
Foles.
Nick Foles. Foles.
But that was late in the year. That wasn't.
But that doesn't matter.
That was week three. Did he start? Week three against the Jets? Or I'm trying to remember now.
Whatever. But still, yeah. Once it went down.
Right.
He came in. He took them to the Super Bowl. Who would say, oh, a second, you know, whatever QB?
Not a, but this guy's a rookie. Baker Mayfield's a rookie. For a rookie.
He wants a cookie?
Wow, you really just, wow, you gotta hit that drum because you just rhymed that stuff. Man, a rookie cookie. That's nice. That was nice, Jeremy. Wow, what play on words for you.
But I have to say one thing. He does not deserve it.
Nice job. That's what I'm clapping
for. For one reason.
For one reason. Not two, not three. One reason. What's the one reason?
One reason.
What's the one reason?
He hasn't proven squat.
Oh, he hasn't proven. Wait a minute. So you're telling me a guy who's taking a team who's 0-16 and turning them into a possible playoff team, you're telling me that is not statue worthy?
No.
I'm sorry. That
one performance.
How?
One performance, yes. People could do that.
Right.
The only thing is,
but an entire
the
season.
Ones that keep continuing. You look at LeBron James. When he came back to Cleveland, they never had less than 50 wins after that.
Let me see it. Let me see the proof. I want to see the proof. Because I don't believe you, to be honest with you. I don't.
Jeez. This is going to be fun. Except not for... Let's see.
Because I personally don't believe you at this point. I don't. Because I think what you're saying about a bunch of Baker Hughes stuff.
Okay. Do-do-do-do. Oh, look. Last year, 50. 51. 57. 53.
Oh, my God. Now I look stupid on air. Wow, I look stupid. You just love that button.
No, I know that. Ever when he came back, that we won 33 games. After that, we won at least 50 games or more.
And guess what? We beat a 73-9 Warriors team to win an NBA championship.
But still,
that's
yeah.
Impressive. That is impressive.
It goes back to one thing.
And what's that one thing, Jeremiah?
He proved one thing right there.
Okay.
Being in the playoffs,
mm-hmm.
getting there down to the finals,
mm-hmm.
he proved he can win. He can prove that he could take you farther. And then even that, you look at the resume here and that,
right,
which it's still not bad. Look, 50-50 that, you know, 45, 66, 61 in that, in the semis or in the finals and that. He's shown one thing and one thing only.
And what is that?
He'll repeat a performance. He'll get you far into it. So Baker gets us to the Super Bowl.
Okay.
How many people make it to the Super Bowl once and never see it again? Like Peyton Manning, he didn't get up there many times to the Super Bowl. Made it to the playoffs a lot. Yeah, you could run down that list. But it's a lot of people. Heck, you could even look at... Dalton, what, one or two times he got him into the first round of the playoffs and that, and they bust. Or no, the one time he got him in. Second time he ended up getting hurt in that, then it was A.J. McCarron's show.
Right.
But still, yeah, they got to the first round, they busted out.
I'll say, you might want to look on Twitch. I just put something out. Nothing inappropriate, just something out. Just so our viewers know what to do. Let us know your opinion on Baker Mayfield. I just want to hear people's opinion because it's going to be laughable.
It's laughable to think, let's go build a statue if he can get us to the Super Bowl.
In one year. As a rookie. Has any rookie quarterback ever gone to a Super Bowl in his rookie year?
I'll guarantee it. Probably somebody out
Fine.
There.
Fine. Let's see it. I want to see this. Let's see it. Could you name three off the top of your head?
No, I wasn't alive during all these.
Okay.
And you can't because you're not even that old either.
I'm 19 years old, thank you.
Exactly.
Right.
No, you could be, you know, talking that and somewhat filling, you know, the blanks.
What are you talking about? What do you mean?
Instead of you just, you know, hear that silent dead air while I'm searching this up.
Oh, yeah, I could be saying something. True, true. True, true. But, I mean, yeah, let's see what we got. I mean, and I want to let you guys know again, please, we actually have now, after 3 Twitter accounts, we have an official one that we're going to keep forever. And I'm going to give you guys it right now as I'm looking at my phone. This is the official Twitter account for The Sports Show. The account is at The Sports Show 216. No spaces, all caps, The Sports Show 216. You can tweet at us, give us your opinions, give us your best Baker Mayfield meme for sure, because I've seen a lot of those out on the internet. So give us your best Baker Mayfield meme, tweet it at us. We'll show it on air if it's appropriate. That's the only thing, is you got to watch what you put out there. So, let you know your opinions during our show, and you know, and also call at us. What, Jeremiah? What's the number again? I don't even remember the number. The call in number.
440-940-6615.
There's the number for you guys. If you guys want to call into the show right now, we're on until about 7:30-ish, right? Or thereabouts. I'm trying to think now.
Let's see.
7:30, but. Yeah, we'll be on until about 7:15-ish, you know, right up to kickoff of the Monday Night Football game. So you guys can go and watch that game over on ESPN later tonight at around 8 o'clock, 8:15-ish. And also, shout out to the students here at Lakeland. Study, 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 and hopefully you guys do well in those finals this week. So,
right here, it's 6 rookie QBs that took their teams to the conference championship.
But that was in a Super Bowl. That's the thing. I asked Super Bowl.
It doesn't matter. Still yet. Because he took us to the Super Bowl. Still yet would build a statue for LeBron first. Because
you know what? The Super Bowl is the mecca of the NFL. And in my opinion, if Baker Mayfield could do that in his first year as a rookie quarterback, he deserves a statue. He deserves a monument. He deserves to be on the Mount Rushmore of the NFL. Period.
And you realize that last one, there's no such thing. That's your complete imagination, right?
Oh, people have it.
There's no Mount Rushmore of the NFL.
Well, in people's heads. Like Peyton Manning's on the Mount Rushmore of the NFL.
So? Tom Brady. I have a picture of me on a wall and that with making over $1 million. Doesn't mean it's going to actually happen. Anyone can dream and insert something random.
True, true, true. But like in my opinion, Baker Mayfield deserves a statue. So we want to get you guys' opinion again. Tweet at me. You know, go into the chat room on Twitch.
Baker doesn't deserve a statue.
Give us your best case scenario. Does Baker Mayfield deserve a statue in the city of Cleveland? Does he deserve that downtown? Does he deserve a banner on the Sherwin-Williams building where the LeBron James banner used to be, and now a banner of what is it? You were telling me and another kid this morning about what that was on the Sherwin-Williams building.
God, I'm ashamed that you guys are Cleveland fans.
Well, here, explain it. It's a little history lesson for all you listeners. It's a little history lesson courtesy of Jeremiah. Take it away.
No, I'm not going to do it. Yeah. No, I'm just going to tell you one thing. I'm ashamed that you guys are Cleveland fans.
No, Jeremiah, this is a little history lesson. Come on.
I mean, seriously, go in and say, well, that bridge picture sucks and that on the side of that. That bridge was here longer before even Baker Mayfield was even
now,
alive.
Now give the viewers and the listeners a little history lesson about that. What is that statue exactly, or that thing you're supposed to be? What is it exactly?
It's a picture of one of the bridge. What's carving into
what is that
one of the pillars?
What is that a symbolism of, or symbol of? I don't know. I'm sorry. I live in Cleveland, but I don't know. I live in the state of Ohio, and I don't know.
I'm going
to
make you do research. I've been telling you all this other stuff. So I should make you do the research of this. Right. Irony.
I'll say I am the host, so. And you're the one controlling the board.
Including, I'm the one that's, you know, told you about Bottlegate and blah, blah, blah.
No. That was Dave. Dave was the first one to tell me about Bottlegate. That was Dave. Dave was the first one when we were talking about.
No, I wouldn't explain what happened and all that stuff.
Dave showed me the video.
No, I showed you the video.
I thought it was Dave.
No.
Okay. Well, it's just about 5:30, so we're going to do a little session.
Not including the other thing is, before you go into that.
Yeah.
I said that, and Dave said, well, you didn't hear about Bottlegate?
True, true. So it's just about 5:30, so we got a little premiere of a commercial that'll be airing. this little Playing Against Sports ad that we put together for Playing Against Sports and Lindhurst. The first look at it, here we go.
Playing Against Sports in Lindhurst wants to buy your used sporting goods. Bring your gently used gear to Playing Against Sports and get paid. Playing Against Sports in Lindhurst buys and sells both new and used sporting goods. Come check out their great selection of golf, baseball, snowboards, fitness equipment, and more. Don't forget to bring your used gear to trade in and trade up. Visit Playing Against Sports in Lindhurst at 5455 Mayfield Road in Lindhurst, Ohio, in the plaza with Buffalo Wild Wings. Come check out Playing Against Sports in Lindhurst today.
Wow, that sounded very good, I must say. Talked a little fast, but that was pretty good.
I had three different versions. I'm still
You're still working on it? Well, that was was that the first version? I say that.
That's the second one. I'll say that. It's three different cuts, three different backgrounds.
I'll say that music sounded a little too loud, I must say.
Playing Against Sports in Lindhurst wants to buy your youth.
Oh, God, no. That was
Playing Against Sports in Lindhurst wants to buy your youth sporting.
I like that. What song was that by John Fogerty about baseball? Oh my God, can't think of it now.
It's somewhat like
you know what I'm talking about?
No, that was actually a free source of sound effects and that I found that on.
No, I'll say that.
Or was that when Spencer told me, "Hey, I'm paying for all this music rights and that. Go download a bunch of stuff off his account." I think that was the one.
I'll say here's the song. If you guys are not familiar with the song, let me see if I can pull it up. After this ad on my phone, I'm gonna play it right into the mic. Or if you want to give me the thing, Jeremiah, you can. If it reaches that far.
No, it's not going to reach that far.
Do you recognize that?
No, that's not even close.
It's close. I'll say play that ad again. Let me just hear it because it sounded like it. I swear.
Playing Against Sports in Lindhurst wants to buy your used sporting goods. Bring your gently used gear to Playing Against Sports and
totally
get paid.
Different
Playing
time
Against
signature.
Sports in Lindhurst buys and sells both new and used sporting goods. Come check out their great selection of golf, baseball, snowboards, fitness equipment, and more. Don't forget to bring your used gear to trade in and trade up. Visit Playing Against Sports in Lindhurst at 5455 Mayfield Road in Lindhurst, Ohio, in the plaza with Buffalo Wild Wings. Come check out Playing Against Sports in Lindhurst today.
Totally different time signature, totally different even clapping of it.
Okay.
Totally different.
It sounded
even
similar.
Backgrounds.
Do you get where I was coming from with that song and that music? Do you get where I was coming from?
I'm really picky about music. That wasn't close.
Oh, okay. I'd say that what was that, the first one? Is that the first version?
Yeah.
I'll say definitely put that one on the loop or whatever that was. Mm-hmm. It the playback? Is that what it's called? Playback?
No.
Okay, never mind then. I'm stupid.
You're fired.
Yes, I am. There we go. So, now I want to talk a little bit about the Heisman Trophy as it was it was given away on Saturday night in New York City at PlayStation Theater. It was kind of expected. Kyler Murray, Oklahoma quarterback, took it. He had 2,195 votes.
I didn't even
overall.
Watch
yeah, it was
it.
Like two. Yeah, it was 2,195 votes overall. And then Tua Tagovailoa was second, followed by Dwayne Haskins with 795 votes. Very shocking. But, Kyler Murray, you said you hate Oklahoma, correct?
Yeah.
For what reason? Give me a reason why you hate Oklahoma. Because I personally...
They're overrated.
Personally, I love Texas. Go hook them.
They're completely overrated.
I completely agree with you.
And honestly, if they really think about bringing Lincoln Riley to the NFL,
yep.
He's just going to fall on his face.
Like
he can't play.
So
with
like
that.
You, he's gonna fall on his face like Hugh Jackson. Is that
no.
Your
thing? No, Hugh's proved one thing. Even though you keep throwing him under the bus, he's more of a man than sure you. Yeah, I did just go there.
Wait, what'd you just say? I was.
He said he's more of a man than you.
Yeah. Oh my. Wow, Jeremiah, wow, you really just insulted me like that, man.
Well, no, because you sit here and that it's all his fault, the team sucks.
It is.
Blah,
it is.
Blah, blah, blah,
it is.
All that.
If you ask anybody, now here, I want to get to a point before we keep going
with
this
stuff. No, he's the one that called the, plays in that, not Haley and
now,
all
here,
this other
I want,
stuff.
Here, I want to get to a point before we continue, because I know we're on a college campus. I want to get to this point very quickly. We had talked about Kareem Hunt last week, about his whole situation and all those situations and everything. Jeremiah, I want to ask you a question personally. if you were an athlete, professional, college, high school, middle school, whatever, would you go and celebrate a loss? What would you do? Would you celebrate a loss? I'm going to give you two options. Would you celebrate a loss, meaning go to somewhere, you know, go to a friend's house and hang out or whatever? Or would you watch game film and think about what you need to fix before the next game?
Well, going in the perspective of the actual scenario of that was in the playoffs and all
that. I don't care what the situation was. I'm saying, as an athlete, would you celebrate a loss by going? Would you celebrate a loss? Or
no,
would you
putting this in the scenario of what happened.
Right.
Of that was during the playoffs.
Right.
I wouldn't go home and start studying film.
I would. Because you know what? You try to regroup and you try to work on what you need
for
to work on.
For one reason.
What?
You had the whole off season.
So? So what? If you ask any high school athlete, any college athlete, they'll say, go home, look at game film, and look at what they need to fix.
Not nowadays.
But hey, he had millions. So I want to get off that topic because, you know, that's a little history. So he will be going into counseling. Just a update on that.
He's a PR stunt.
You might as well play the drum for that. Why would you call it a PR stunt?
Dude, that's the only reason, since it got published and not including,
you're
you
like,
know,
PR stunt.
The two other incidences on top of it.
Now, wait a minute.
Completely PR stunt.
Okay, okay. So you're
trust
saying,
me, I guarantee if this just kept in between a team and didn't get released all over and all that, he wouldn't have went out if it was, he was still in Kansas City.
Right.
They found out, hey, I did this, and it didn't leak out at all.
Right.
Guarantee he wouldn't have been going to this level.
Okay.
I guarantee he would have, you know, not did a thing. He went into anger management or whatever.
So you're saying if he had not told the Kansas City Chiefs anything, he would not have been, he would have gone.
No, if he went and told just the team,
yes,
it didn't leak out on TMZ and all that other stuff.
Right.
He wouldn't have done it.
He wouldn't have gone to counseling and all that?
Yes.
So you're saying, you said, Pearson, were your exact words. But, I mean, it's common today. It sucks to say it. That it's common, you know, the whole domestic violence. I mean, it's an issue. But, I mean, it's an issue of what, you know, we were talking this morning before the morning show about, you know, is it right for a woman to hit a man? Now, the one thing I don't get, and this is something you learn as a kid, you know, in middle school, you know, what bullies do, and I've learned this over the years, bullies, they will say something, they will say anything to you to make you flip your switch, if you know what I mean by that. They will make you, they want you to react. And in my opinion, this woman wanted him to react in the way that he did. Because you know what she wanted? Big payout. She wanted the big payout. She wanted the money. You know what I'm saying? She wanted the money. She wanted the money from the investigation, the court stuff, all that. So that's the reason why she said what she said. And what I heard from the guy that I was talking to this morning before the morning show was that she said some explicit words that, you know, made him flip his switch. And in my opinion, that was a bully's stunt right there.
Except devil's advocate coming out.
Devil's advocate?
Oh, yeah.
What are you talking about?
Hearing that somebody's walking up. Did he say anything from the vows before he walked out in front of the camera?
My guess is no. Because it doesn't seem like his lips
are
moving.
Are you sure?
Well, you know what?
Well, no, before he showed up from around the corner.
Do you? I'll say pull up the video. Let's see this. I want to see this again because
before he came up around the corner, that his buddy or somebody said something.
In my opinion,
did
he didn't say
go
anything.
And say something
hey, from the video. He did not look like he was saying anything. I didn't want to get into this topic, but you know what? Let's get into this topic. Let's do some more debating. Let's do a little Max Kellerman, Stephen A. Smith impersonation. Because I want to say something. Because, I mean, for all you women listening and are out there, you know, either in breakers or at home or whatever, watching this, I respect women wholeheartedly. I do. And for what Kareem Hunt did, I am ashamed. I am upset because of what he did. He did something a guy should never do. I mean, it blows my mind to see exactly what he did. He did not. I mean, you watch the video and you see exactly what he did. It was like this guy, you know, he said, oh, you know, I know right from wrong, you know, to Lisa Salters. As Jeremiah said, that was a PR stunt. And I completely, and you know what? I take back everything, all the forgiveness stuff I said about to Kareem Hunt. I take all that back, to be honest with you, Jeremiah. I take all that back. Because it was wrong. I mean, no matter what someone says to you, you don't get physical. I mean, if the person gets physical with you, then yeah, fight back. That's what you do. But if, in the case of it being a man and a woman, you don't get physical with
like
a woman.
Like right here. What? Do you see his mouth is sort of open and that?
Because she, because you...
You don't know what he said back here.
My guess is he was walking.
You, me, and nobody knows that answer.
Unless someone comes in contact with
him. Then even
police.
Right here.
I'll say we can very easily ask someone who does lip reading. Or we can get someone with a camera angle from there. Because in my opinion, you like right there, he pushes her.
Not including he goes and you could tell he mouths something, at least at first, that sure was a... I'll sort of put one thing. It was what? A five-letter word. Sir with a B.
What?
Right here. Let's go back here.
Oh, I had another word.
Right here.
I know the exact
right
word.
Right there when he pushed her the first time.
I know the word now. You guys will probably know the same word as me. It's, I'm not going to say the word because it'd be inappropriate for on-air use, so I'm not going to say it. So, but...
You could just tell by his lips.
So that's what he said?
Yes.
So you're saying
I would be 100% sure if I had a Ripley or a lip reader.
Yes.
Could be 100%. But I'm good 90% sure on that.
Okay.
I'm 90% sure on that, of that.
That's insane. I mean, I wish we could get some of, I mean... I wonder what who's the lieutenant of the police department? Was it Steve or Scott? Shoot, I forgot now.
Steve.
Steve. Wonder what he would say. I wonder if he could do some lip reading for us. I bet you he could.
He's not certified in that.
So you're saying he couldn't look at that video and say, "Oh, this is what he said."
No.
Oh, okay.
He's a police officer.
So there were police involved in this situation. Couldn't he? I mean, he could probably tell us.
Do they go to school for lip reading?
No.
Exactly.
But I bet you he could tell us what exactly would be done. Like, what I would like to know, and Steve, if you're watching this or if you're listening, what would your punishment be if this was no, and if this was not an NFL player, if Kareem Hunt was just some man, not an NFL star, nothing like that, what would the punishment be for this sort of situation? I'd like to get your input on this, because I know you're the lieutenant of the police department here at Lakeland. I want to get your opinion on this, because. To be honest with you, in my opinion, I know I'm not a police officer. I've never gone into that stuff. But in my opinion, he'd probably get a couple years in prison, if that. But I know you'll probably have other ideas with that. But, you know, Steve, I'd love to get your opinion on that. So if you have the time at some point tonight, if you're here.
No, he's gone.
Oh, he's gone? Well, yeah. Maybe I'll say maybe if I'm on your show Wednesday morning, I'll definitely have to ask you that question for sure. Because, I mean, it just I don't know how to say this, but it makes me upset. It says, I have so much anger right now. It makes me sick to my stomach to see what he did and to think he's doing all this stuff, as you said, for a PR stunt. This guy should be nowhere near the cameras. He should not be allowed to talk to anybody. He should be in solitary confinement.
Well, no, the sad thing is one thing.
What?
ESPN going and saying, oh, yeah, sure.
We'll do an interview. Right. Which was wrong. Because then, in my opinion, as you said, he asked for them to have Lisa Salters interview him. He wanted a woman to interview him for the exact reason of to make him look better.
That's the smart thing, is that would make him look better. Except the only bad thing is two releases of two other things happened.
Right.
Not even 24 hours later. The irony train really found a way home.
To be honest,
on that.
Kudos to TMZ. I mean, you got to give TMZ a lot of credit for that, for basically ending Kareem Hunt's career by putting out the video, putting out the other two releases. I mean, TMZ did a hell of a job doing that. Kudos to TMZ. I love to give kudos to them. That is some good work on their part.
Now, the NFL could actually dig some dirt up on that.
Right, and see if there was some relationship with this girl that we don't know with Kareem Hunt.
Especially with them not working with the police now.
Right, you said like something about like...
One and two. It's pretty coincidental.
Right.
that makes you it smells very fishy still yet.
Oh, definitely. Almost definitely.
Except one thing.
What's that?
I still think it's something that's being not told.
So you're saying it's something with money involved?
No. Maybe that. Maybe it's another incident out there.
So you're saying...
There's something still out there.
So you're saying there's some other incident that he did, like, somewhere, like...
It's something out there somewhere.
I'll say,
I can't imagine... If it's only three, that doesn't seem correct. It's got to be something lurking out there.
I say, look it up. Why don't we do some searching of our own? Let's see if we can find something else. I mean, who knows? There could be another article out there by Cream Hunt doing something stupid. And you know what? You'll hear it first here on Liquid Factory. So let's take a look. But while Jeremiah's looking that up, I want to remind everybody. I know I reminded you guys twice already, but Play It Again, the sports show is brought to you by Play It Again Sports in Lyndhurst. Play It Again Sports, the neighborhood sporting goods store where we buy, sell, and trade new and used sporting goods. They're the number one place to buy your sporting goods. When you're, you know, on your way to a ball game and you need to get something quick, you run to Play It Again Sports in Lyndhurst. Right next to Buffalo Wild Wings in Mayfield. You can visit them at 5455 Mayfield Road in Lyndhurst, Ohio. As I said before, on the plaza next to Buffalo Wild Wings. Or you could call them at 440-461-8474. The guys there are the best. I mean, they'll help you through everything. If you call them, they'll help you. If you're there, they've got great customer service. I mean, it's spot on. I work there, and I'm giving my opinion, and people love it there. I mean, it's awesome. You know, people come in, and we help them, and, you know, you'll get great, great support, great customer service, and, you know, visit Play It Again Sports in Lyndhurst today. All right, let's see. What, Jeremiah, did you get any more dirt? Did you dig any?
This might explain a lot that the owner of the Chiefs knew about all this.
Ooh. So
that
he's
sort
like,
of explains so why he got released.
So you're saying he's like a Joe Paterno. This guy was quiet about the whole thing.
Right here, Chiefs were aware at least of three off-field issues being investigated. Yeah, the team owner, Clark Hunt, was told Sunday, a week after they, you know, cut ties with him. I'm not shocked. With them releasing him just after that one, Sir just screamed, it's not just one. It's something more out there. So that explains why they released him. Because I figured they must have known at least about some other incidences that happened.
So you're saying, that basically the Chiefs owner was like a Joe Paterno. He was quiet about it all until now. Is that what you're saying?
So this was when was this released? Was it Sunday morning?
Jeez.
So, yes.
Jeez, oh man.
So, yeah, a week later, yeah, they knew about it, all three of them. See, they wouldn't just release them just because that one.
Right.
That brings into the thing of they did know about at least three. God knows if it's another one or two that they know of.
Oh, my God. Then the Chiefs owner is going to get a punishment, in my opinion. I would not be all that surprised if he gets a punishment. You know? I mean...
Because that's the one thing is, they say about three involving him. They don't say which ones.
Right.
They don't say the ones that have been reported.
Right.
They just say three.
Okay.
With how vague it is...
Right.
Who knows?
True.
We'll find out.
True. I mean, and you know, we'll definitely be discussing this on the Scott and Steve show. I don't know what their plans are, but I know if I'm there, we'll definitely hit on this at least once. But yeah, also, yeah, you're going to do a little something. You listen to the Scott and Steve show. It's on at, what is it, noon? Noon on Wednesday mornings. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Noon Wednesday mornings on here on Lick Factory and streaming live at lickfactory.org/you. Listen to their show. Their show's, man, it's a lot of fun doing their show. I mean, I got to do it last week with them. The man, it's awesome. Their show's awesome. So definitely listen to their show. You know, you definitely do the same content as us. You know, it's a lot of fun. So listen to their show. It's Wednesday mornings at noon here on Lake Factory and streaming live at lakefactory.org/studio. Now I want to get back to some more Kareem Hunt talk. I mean, and I also want to get your guys' opinion, please, listeners, viewers, anybody. If you're out in breakers doing some studying, you want to take a nice break, answer this question. Please come into the studio if you want to. And you can very easily just sit in and talk to us because I want to get someone's opinion on this. Kareem Hunt as Jeremiah said, it's a PR stunt. Is it a PR stunt for him to go into counseling? Is it? That's what I'm posing to you guys out there if you're in breakers or at home.
He's trying to sit there and show some kind of faith. It's right now, if he doesn't do anything, no one's going to touch him. Flat out.
Right.
So he's got to make some kind of thing.
True. True.
That's almost, you know, a boss that's in a manufacturing thing. He doesn't know how to work a fire extinguisher. All of a sudden, a fire breaks out, and, you know, he's the only one there, and the whole place burns down. Are you going to go and hire the guy that doesn't know how to work a fire extinguisher?
So you're basically saying that the fire is these three scenarios?
No. One by one? I'm just saying, in basic, you have this manager.
Right.
Doesn't know how to work a fire extinguisher. He's by himself in that. Place catches on fire. He doesn't know how in that. He goes, calls 911. It burns all the ways down. Company's going to be a little skeptical of going and try to, you know, if he went and left for another company, go and, you know, say, hey, you know, why are you at your previous job? And well, it burnt down because I didn't know how to work a fire extinguisher. You think companies would be, you know.
Hell no.
Not including say, OSHA would be wondering say, a lot of stuff,
I'll
too.
Say, speaking of that, pull up, what was it, Will Smith doing? Oh, hell nah. Pull that up, please. That's a good all hell nah moment right there. You gotta pull that up.
Oh, good for you.
Perfect.
And how was it?
Perfect. That's better than all hell nah. That's perfect. But yeah, I mean, it's you. What was your point again? I don't even remember. It just went right over my head. I'm sorry. What was your
Companies
point?
Would be hesitant in hiring someone that doesn't know how to work a fire extinguisher if their former place of employment burnt down.
I say, would we just speak? I'm sorry to go off topic, but would we just see a puppy? I swear to God, I thought I saw a puppy out of the corner.
I don't
of my
know.
Eye. I thought I just saw a puppy out of the corner of my eye. Oh my God.
I wasn't looking up there.
I was like, I just
not going to on air lights or blocks things.
I say, I just saw it on my. Some boy was carrying a puppy.
Oh, good for you. And how was it? I hope it was good because it's useless now, isn't it?
Wow, you just love that. Man, you just love those buttons, man. You're just a button-pushing kind of guy.
No, I just get bored and add all kind of different buttons in.
Also, you gotta get that Will Smith all hell no. You gotta put that in there.
You want answers? I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth! You can't handle the truth!
Wow! That's Wow, Jeremiah. Man, you should be a comedian. That's good. Wow.
Yeah, I get bored.
Also, I want to give a shout-out. You got to love those Texans Longhorns. They'll be playing in the All-State Sugar Bowl on the 29th of December. Should be a heck of a... Or is it New Year's... Is it New Year's Eve? Or it's at some point. Texas and Georgia will be playing. Hook 'em. You know what, you're my man? I want to say something on air, but I can't. I want to say
if
something...
If you're a Texas fan, you should know where they're played.
They're playing against Georgia at the All-State Sugar Bowl.
When?
New Year's Day. New Year's Day, like, night. Man, Jeremiah, you're pushing
you're
my
You're not a real fan if you don't know.
Hook 'em.
That's like me. I know what fail to the victor is.
Oh, that's the Michigan. Why would you speak of that?
One reason.
Steve.
Well, no. After 100-something years, you got to know your rival just a little.
True, true.
And you got to know that one song that you just want to hit the mute button for. A little too soon?
Nah, that's not too soon at all.
So, yeah.
I'll say a little update. For all those Army veterans out there, Army beat Navy Saturday 17-10. It was a great game. It was, you know, shout out. I want to give a shout out to all those veterans listening. Thank you for your service. You guys do a heck of a lot for us. Thank you. Can't be more proud of you guys, man. You guys give the ultimate sacrifice. And I want to say thank you to all you guys, all you service men and women out there listening or. Here at Lakeland, thank you for your service. You know, you fight for our freedoms, and you know what? We give you the ultimate respect for that. So thank you. So, and an update on the Georgia game is actually it is New Year's Day night. It is. Wait, is it? Shoot, I don't remember. Shoot.
Thank God you searched it up.
Yeah, thank God. Yeah, yes, it is. It is an 8:45 game, New Year's Day night, at 8 p.m., 8:45 p.m. Eastern on ESPN. It'll be number 15, Texas, and number 5, Georgia. You better not hit that boo button, I swear. You better not, Jeremiah. God. Man, Jeremiah. You're pushing.
I get bored.
Man, I seriously, not to be rude.
I push all the buttons.
I seriously want to give you a backhand right now, but I know I can't.
Because it would be filmed your assault?
Correct. Hey, just like Kareem Hunt. Kareem Hunt, I hope you know this, but just remember there's cameras in your residence. Just remember that. I know you're not blind. Just remember there's cameras. I mean, wow, Jeremiah, this is making me tired. Shoot.
No, wait, really think on that.
What?
Really think on it.
I don't know what the heck you're talking about. What the heck?
Really think on it.
What are you doing? What's going on here? What'd you just do?
No, it is what is what I do. See, Jeopardy rolls.
Yep. Kudos to Jeremiah for that. But hey, I mean, you know, with the whole Kareem Hunt situation, you know what? It's kind of a pain in the butt to talk about. You know what I mean? Kind of a pain.
Yeah, it happens. But you know,
things happen. People do stupid stuff, and you know what? They get themselves into trouble, and then it becomes a PR stunt. As Jeremiah said. Oh, what are you pulling up now?
What do you like to know?
I'd love to know that.
No one ever knows what I do.
Pull it up, Jeremiah. Come on.
I'm waiting for the right moment. So what's your next topic?
Oh, man. I personally... Shoot. I don't know what to talk about. What do you want to talk about? What is wrong with you, Jeremiah? Come on. You gotta be kidding me. I'll say, why don't you play some,
God damn you. Well, you're the person, the headliner, that should be telling me what we're talking about in that.
I'm just a really hard critic. I say, are you a fan of boxing? Just out of curiosity.
I don't really watch boxing.
I'll say there's a huge fight on Saturday night. Vasily Lomachenko and Jose Pedraza. Yeah, he fought Saturday night at Madison.
Wait, what?
What are you doing?
That was a car kidding.
Why'd you just interrupt me? I was just talking. I was on a roll.
Wait, who was their names again?
Vasily Lomachenko and Jose Pedraza.
God, that's a mouthful.
And they fought Saturday night at the Hulu Theater at Madison Square Garden. Just a reminder, if you guys don't know about Madison Square Garden, there's actually convention centers inside of Madison Square Garden. It's not just the main attraction of Madison Square Garden. It's a whole bunch of smaller convention centers at Madison Square Garden. So they fought at the Hulu Theater at Madison Square Garden. It's a heck of a fight. There was an earlier fight. Who was it? Oh, my God. Jose Perez, I think it was, I believe. I'll say, pull it up. Pull it up. It was Jose Perez. I forgot the guy's name. It was a clean knockout. I couldn't believe it. Just go to the Vasily. It was, oh my God, what was it? It was like, not Filippo. Just go to the Vasily Lomachenko, Jose Pedraza fight card. And there should be a list of the names of the guys. You got to see this. I mean, for you guys who are listening, please, if you're near a laptop or a phone, if you're on your phone, please look this up. If you're a boxing fan, you've got. I mean, it was the cleanest knockout I've ever seen. I couldn't believe it.
Was it Alex? Hey, Leo.
What?
Earth the Ryan.
Yeah.
Come in.
I'm looking it up on my phone right now. I'm looking up the guy's name because it's on the ESPN app, so I can look it up. You might as well play the Jeopardy music right now if you want to. That kind of hurts my ears. Thank you.
Never said it was going to be as funny.
Let's
you know, all of them can't be winners.
True.
To a point. Or is this it?
Oh, here we go. It was Teofimo Lopez. Teofimo Lopez. That's what the guy's name was.
This must be the one. Except need to find the video. Oh, shoot. No, that's from, like, 2008.
It's Teo... you look up Teofimo Lopez Knockout 2018 Saturday night, you'll find it. And for your viewers, I want to remind you guys, this was a clean knockout. It was like the guy's eyes rolled to the back of his head. It was so crazy. I couldn't believe it. I mean, it was here's a stat for you guys. This knockout happened 44 seconds into the fight. Mark my word, it happened 44 seconds into the fight. 44. And guess what? You didn't have to pay for it. It was on ESPN on Saturday night, and he had to pay for it. And the fight lasted 44 seconds. How crazy. Man, something. Say, Jeremiah, do I just pull it up on my phone? I could do that.
It doesn't matter much.
I'll pull it up. Show you.
Yeah, but here, it was, on my thing.
Here, it's Teofimo Lopez versus Mason Menard. Did you find it? Here, you just look. It's... Teofimo Lopez. Do you want to spell that? Teofimo.
Lopez.
It should be one of him.
This one?
Yes.
Yeah, the first one. Just watch. It'll happen. Is this the brutal knockout, I believe?
No clue.
If you fast forward just a little bit, it should be coming up. Dang. Right there. You got to rewind it. It's insane. You have to watch it. The guy throws a nasty right hook. And look, I mean, the guy falls flat on his face.
I have to say that's really pathetic.
What do you mean?
You would not say on a hit like that he should be knocked out.
But why? I mean, watch his celebration. He does a little Fortnite celebration. Now watch what he does after. He goes and watch. He's like looking. He's like, oh, where is it? He goes and guess what he finds? Guess what this guy gets him? Where is it? Right. Where is it? Right.
He thinks he's funny because he could pull a Heisman.
Yeah,
move.
He did it. Here,
I'm does he here. Realize what sport he's in?
I'll say here, guys. I'm gonna stand up right now and do a little Heisman for you. Here we go.
Please don't embarrass yourself.
There you go. Little Heisman post for you.
Please don't embarrass yourself.
Wow, Jeremiah, you're rude. I just pulled a Heisman on you. Wow, Jeremiah.
I told you, don't do it so you don't embarrass yourself.
I'm not embarrassing myself.
I can't do anything about the kids laughing.
You just pressed a button.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I mean, what? Oh, God.
You don't know what's hiding up in the ceilings in the studio.
Wow, Jeremiah. Wow.
What?
That's just plain rude. That really hurt my feelings right there. Man, I just pulled a sick Heisman pose on you, and you just start laughing. Wow. That's really rude.
Like I said.
I'll say, what's the next thing you're going to do? Mute my mic so I can't talk? Is that the next thing you're going to do is just to make me look bad?
I can't do anything about what the kids do.
There's no kids up in the attic. God. We all know it.
There's no kids. An attic?
Or not in the attic, in the ceiling. Oh, my God. Oh, no.
Please don't. No, don't.
I did that pretty good. Oh, no. Oh, no. Man, we do some funny things on this show. I give my board operator, Jeremiah, a lot of credit. He does a very good job of doing this. So thank you, Jeremiah. You do a great job. No! I just complimented you.
I don't know what they do up there in the ceiling.
Jeremiah, I see your hand near the mouse. I'm not stupid.
Are you sure?
I'm not blind. True. I'm here. I can see.
It's not on the no button.
Yes, it is.
No.
Oh, my God. So, Jeremiah, how was your weekend?
You suck.
No, I purposely did that.
I hate you. So, Jeremiah, how was your weekend? I want to ask you that question. I'm asking you a question. Why are you? It's like, get your hands off the mouse. How was your weekend, Jeremiah?
Just a normal weekend.
Watch the Browns get a victory. Hashtag Dub Nation.
Hashtag working.
Okay. I was at work Saturday, but then I got to watch the Browns game. You know what? Hashtag Browns Nation. Hashtag Browns Nation. Hashtag Dub Nation. There you go. So.
That's a thing.
What?
That's a thing.
Dub Nation?
Yeah.
Yes. And Browns Nation's coming up. Oh, yeah. Dog Pound.
Learn something new every day.
Now it's going to be Browns Nation. You heard it here first. It's going to be Browns Nation. That's what the fans are going to be called. They're going to be called Browns Nation. All you guys listening here at Lakeland and around the state of Ohio, we're Browns Nation. We're not Dog Pound anymore. We're Browns Nation. We're Dub Nation.
T of murder in the first degree.
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh yeah!
Yeah, don't have words for that one, huh?
I don't know what the heck to say for that. I'm sorry. That was rude. That was rude. Very rude.
Oh, boo-hoo! Let me play a sad song for you on the world's smallest violin. This is serious. I know. This really is the world's smallest violin. See?
That's Baker Mayfield. You made an impression of Baker Mayfield just now.
Yeah.
By Hugh Jackson.
I know. And you know the funny thing is, if I could honestly go out and buy a violin like that, I would be the one that went and did that.
I'll say, since it's Christmas time, Jeremiah, why don't you pull up Angry Browns Fan Christmas? I want some people, I don't know if you guys have listened to this.
Does he have any new stuff?
No, but it's all... But you know
God,
what?
I'll
say, for those people who have not heard it, Jeremiah, please, if you could find the playlist, please play it. You guys are going to laugh when you hear this. It's kind of funny to hear what this guy does. He basically takes Christmas songs and browns them up, if you know what I mean. He brownifies
Not
them.
Not really.
He brownifies them. He makes them like brown season, so to speak.
He somewhat inserts the Browns' disappointment into them.
Right. So he brownifies them. No. Not to sound like a racist or anything, but he brownifies them. So, while Jeremiah's doing that, I want to remind you guys that the Sports Show is brought to you by Play It Against Sports in Lyndhurst. Play It Against Sports, the neighborhood sporting goods store where we buy, sell, and trade new and used sporting goods. Visit Play It Against Sports in Lyndhurst at 5455 Mayfield Road in Lyndhurst, Ohio, right next to Buffalo Wild Wings on Mayfield Road. You can call us at
440-464-8474.
Visit Play It Against Sports today, the best sporting goods store in Lyndhurst.
I didn't realize he released this one.
Which one?
Stranger Things, Cleveland Browns Edition, Chapter 1.
Oh, play it. Let's play it. I know we're supposed to.
I don't know what that is.
I'll say play the Angry Browns Fan because I know that one's censored. So we're good. So we're, there's no nothing bad.
What, 2015 all over again?
Our present to you.
No, wait, that's not the different guy. Different guy. You gotta go to the other guy. Over yet?
Take a listen.
You gotta go to the other one. There should be another one.
Oh my God!
It should be another one with another guy because that guy did not look familiar. It's the one with like he's got like the glasses.
What, this guy? The Sad Factory Sadness?
No, let me see. Let me see if I can find it. I'll show you. Let's see if I can find this one for you guys.
Could just listen to this.
Here it is. It's a very Angry Browns Fan Christmas.
The Angry Browns Fan collaborates with fans to create a very Angry
yeah,
Browns Fan
that's
Christmas.
That's who I was on.
Two, the fan redo. Take a listen.
Draft a QB 22nd. Fell. Every Sunday, watch the wreckage. Fell. As fans, we wear our Browns apparel. Fell. To save my mind, I sing these carols. Fell. You are rotten.
Cleveland Browns. You bring my spirits down. You make me think you're gonna win and then lose it in the end. Cleveland Browns, just answer this one question. When are you gonna turn this thing around?
#2018.
I thought we'd be better.
I really hated this one.
It was funny.
Every Sunday, fans lay it off the line. Well, you know it's Cleveland, and I know this much is true.
I can really live with this one.
Baby, put a QB under the tree for me. We've
yes.
had a bad team lately. Jimmy, baby, just do that one big favor for me. So that was Campbell. And what has he done?
Nothing.
Another game over. And a loss for Cleveland. It's the most blunderful time of the year. Don't think. There'll be much intercepting and not much connecting. The goal line's not near. It's the most blunderful time of the year. Gordon, can he be our guy? Every catch we scream his name.
Gordon!
Will he stay or will he go?
I think we already found that one out.
Seasons will all know. Gordon, Gordon, Gordon. Don't leave us for Pittsburgh.
You want us for New England.
Gordon, Gordon.
We forced that. You realize
Gordon,
that, right?
Yeah, I know.
Stay away from South Beach. Stand in the pocket, waiting there forever. Staring down the wide out forever and ever. Pocket receded, come on out, Whedon. Drop for a sack, loss of three.
Use the hashtag #AngryBrownsFan. Share this video and spread holiday cheer with your friends and family.
When did you find this?
Someone showed me it. One of my family members. Hey, kudos to the people at my family in Chicago. They showed me this video. Thank you.
You know you're a few years late on that, right?
No, they showed me this way back. They showed me this way back. I'm bringing it back. They showed me this, like, way back. But, yeah, kudos to my family, my dad's family in Chicago. I love you guys. Shout out to you guys, man. You guys showed me this video. I loved it. Gotta love it. They're Bears fans for life, so. They love Trubisky. They love those Chicago Bears, so. But they're somewhat Browns fans as well, so.
Yeah.
But yeah, shout out to those people in Chicago, my family, my dad's family in Chicago who are diehard Browns, or somewhat Browns fans, somewhat Bears fans. I mean, a little bit of both. So, shout out to them.
It's really sad that he hasn't made anything recent.
Like, can you find any other Browns things? Like anybody that has created any video for Christmas? I'll say find the first one. It's a very angry Browns fan Christmas. That one is good. The one you showed is eh. The one that I found is really funny.
With this one?
Just in time for the holidays, we present to you a Bingo. Very Angry Browns Fan Christmas. A superb record collection featuring Cleveland holiday classics. Just listen.
You know Campbell and
this one,
Hoyer,
yes.
Tim Couch, Kelly Holcomb, Dilfer, Garcia, McCown, and Ty Detmer. But do you recall the oldest rookie of all? In the red-haired QB cost a very high draft pick, and if you ever saw him, you would say he plays like
Bears catch the ball, don't drop the ball, most seem to say cut him today.
Trade him, trade him.
Sure, what you think of that set scene? Do you like that, or is that a little that not?
I've seen this before.
I know, it's funny. This is great.
Last season, I gave you my heart, but the very first play, you threw it away. Next year, save me from
or broke, he can't catch the ball.
That was true.
Way up in your lows, Jimmy H.
This was relevant to this year.
Do you see what I see? Do you see what I see?
Would you agree,
way
Jeremiah?
Up in the sky, Jimmy H. Do you see what I see? Do you see what I see? A team
with a QB.
Without a QB and a back who looks 63.
He's really old.
And a back who looks 63.
So Chubb looks like 63.
No.
All the players out there are frightful, but that snuckin' liquor's delightful. And since Whedon can't throw, let him go, let him go, let him go.
And where's Braden Whedon now?
It's
I don't know.
It's beginning to look a lot like Cleveland. Every play that snapped, take a look at the third and ten. Fumbling once
I think he
again.
That guy just literally was looking at us. Like, what are we listening to?
Use the hashtag #AngryBrownsFan with lyrics to your own.
Shout out to my family again, and my dad's family in Chicago for giving us that video.
He did it, not me.
Come on.
See, you frightened people away.
Hey, you know what? It was a great video. It was a fantastic video. It's funny. Man, Jeremiah, man, you're just.
I seen this like years ago.
Same. I just wanted to bring it back because it's Christmas time. I thought I'd bring it back. You know, it's Christmas time.
But the thing is, with a QB, the only thing is you didn't go and denounce the thing of when he went and said, hello. Denounce the thing of a running back that looks 63. Silly Ryan. Tricks yeah. for kids.
Very funny.
Yes.
Oh my god. Ah, nice.
Oh, yeah, man. You know. See, Ryan, you just got put in your place.
Yes, I did. Yes. Wow, Jeremiah, thank you. Thank you for that.
You're welcome. This is what I do.
Yeah, you just humiliate me. Simple
no.
as that.
Humiliating people's not. No, when it comes to Steve and wearing the Ohio State jersey.
Yes.
Now, that's humiliation.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, it's a Michigan fan here. So if you see a random guy walking around in a police white shirt and that with a brown or Ohio State jersey, yeah.
Well, that's the lieutenant of the police department, by the way.
Yeah. That poor guy.
Yep. Well, all we do is troll him. I'll say, pull up one of those Ohio State things. Remember you were playing those things?
What? Could be worse.
What? What could be worse?
Hey, let's get a chair. Get a mic.
Yeah. Yeah, since you're here.
Yeah, since you're here, yeah. So what's your name? Give us your name.
Nathaniel.
Nathaniel? Okay, welcome to the show. This is the sports show. We talk all things sports and, you know, you. So, Jeremiah, what were you saying? You were saying something?
So what's worse?
Yeah, what's worse?
Well, he could be trying to play chess on the field.
Eh. Ooh.
Yeah, true.
Ooh, yeah, that's pretty good. Pretty good.
Mm. Man. I'll be completely honest. I just saw you guys in here and was like, oh, what's going on over there?
Yeah, talking random stuff.
Yeah, talking random stuff. Yeah, oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like us, did you know about the 62% off of the Revenge Tour?
No.
Yeah. The Revenge Tour. Oh, the Michigan thing. Right. I remember that.
Then they lost by 62.
Right. Yeah.
Irony.
Yeah. Shout out to Steve. Steve.
Still hashtag didn't go and steal that from someone. Hashtag made it up.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
But, yeah. I wonder if you saw the Kareem Hunt. Did you hear about the Kareem Hunt situation? No?
No.
No? Okay. I think we were talking about it earlier. It was basically the kid from Willoughby South. You know, his local boy got into an altercation with a woman, you know, did some hit her a few times, this and that. I want to get your opinion. What would you, if you were, now, this was like a bull, like, you know, like, I don't know if you probably know.
It's almost like domestic violence.
Right, but I'm saying, like, if kids are bullied in, like, high school or, like, middle school and that, how the bully will, you know, they'll say something just to get that person, you know, make the flip their switch. Don't you agree that that's, like, basically what that woman did? Because she was saying some things that should not have been said. And do you feel like that's what her intent was, is, okay, I'm going to say something rude to make him blow his top, just like a bully.
Well, as someone that I hasn't heard of this incident up till now, mm-hmm. One would have to listen to the altercation if it was recorded.
There's just a video. I mean, Jeremy, if you want to pull up real quick. But yeah, I mean, it was at a Cleveland hotel. You know, do you know where the Nine is? Downtown, right across the street from Progressive Field.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah,
it's the Nine. It's a newer hotel, a newer residency. Was there, and there was a big video. And basically, he pulled a stunt. It was, what was it, February of this year?
February something.
Yeah, it was February of this year. He got in the video. Just surfaced. I mean, it was unbelievable. But I mean,
yeah, a week ago.
It was a week ago this Friday. Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, a week ago this Friday, or a week ago last Friday. But yeah, I mean, it's kind of sad to see what TMZ actually was able to find, given what he did. I mean,
well, the sad thing is the NFL not finding that.
Right. I mean, they would have to pay TMZ to find it. Or to even get it. See, here's the video. It's the video right here.
Or is it just the three? Or will this actually begin in three?
Yeah.
Ah, there we go. This is the actual video.
All right, here we go. And there's actually an incident right after this where she was on the ground and he actually kicked her. You'll see it in a bit.
Nah, it shall come.
But actually, if you watch it, there's actually another woman who's holding Kareem back. That's what blew my mind. Is you have this other woman who's in the situation as well. Now here, it's right. Is it right here? Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, because she gets pushed into the wall along with one of Kareem's friends, I believe.
Yeah, it's going to be someplace here.
Is it just bits and pieces of the video, or is it the actual...
No, I think it's somewhat because the buffering. Oh, there it goes.
There you go. So that's when... So Kareem had pushed his friend who was knocked into the woman, and then it was right... It should be coming up. Is that Kareem? Wait a minute.
Well, she'll get sort of up right there, and that's when it happened.
And then she'll go back down to her knees right there. And then watch Kareem right there. So it was a little bit buffered. But, yeah, I mean, what's your opinion on that? Do you feel like the NFL...
That's better.
Do you feel like the Chiefs did the right thing by releasing him, one, and two, the NFL, putting him, you know, suspending him indefinitely?
Well, I can never say that violence is properly condoned on really any circumstance.
Right.
So, yeah... It was also probably a chance to save some face in the public eye.
Oh, definitely. I mean, this kid, I mean, he's a local boy, went to Willoughby South. He played very well at Willoughby South. No prior things that I've heard of him in high school.
Well, no, the funny thing is, after this all sort of broke, that it was two other stories that broke out.
Right. The Kansas City nightclub situation where he had... What was it, fractured a guy's ribs?
A month prior to that.
Right. But didn't you think it was like brain contusions of the guy that had his ribs, something like that?
Well, yeah, broken ribs, broken nose, and bruises and
like
stuff.
A brain contusion or something like that.
Yeah.
And then they had the situation of Putin Bay.
Yeah.
Which I found out last...
5 months later after the one
in
February.
Which was in June after a playoff... Was that... No, that wasn't after a playoff loss.
No.
The January one was after the playoff loss.
But it was the one prior to that one that happened
at the Kansas
was a nightclub,
right?
And it was another one that happened 5 months after that one from the hotel happened,
which is, I mean,
in Put-in Bay,
right? Do you know where that is? Put-in Bay, it's right near Kelly's Island. If you go into Sandusky, but it begs the question: do you feel like he'll ever play football again after these situations? Do you see him playing anywhere? Browns, Chiefs, anywhere?
I believe players have gotten off with less eventually.
You make a good point. I mean, players do get off with less. I mean, there is that statement. But, I mean, with it being domestic violence, possibly. I mean, who knows if he actually knew this woman personally. If I mean, that's the only thing that I would beg to question is, was there a relationship prior to?
See, with this, it just comes down to the ifs and the maybes and half-truths that are being spread around. Depending on what the coaches that might want to take him back on hear and believe. Because at that point, mm-hmm. it's all about what they feel is worth the risk. Can their team take the hit, if people even still remember this incident, a month or two down the line?
I mean, I feel like people would remember mm-hmm. it just because all you have to do is look up on YouTube Kareem Hunt situation, and boom, there's that video right there of him on camera at the nine hitting a woman. Simple as that. I mean, I can go up on YouTube right now and look it up. I know it's just surfaced, but I bet you 2 years down or a year down the road, you could look up the situation and you could find the actual video, everything right then and there.
Unfortunately, with how humans are as a species, once one shiny thing gets out of the spotlight, it tends to get forgotten rather quickly.
Right.
Yeah.
And I mean, this is just the latest shiny thing.
Oh, I mean,
the only reason that would be brought up again that people would tither on would be if something happened down the road again.
What, with him?
Yes. If something else happened like that, that they would think, oh, whatever.
This isn't the first time.
Oh, remember this one, you know, from...
It would only be brought up if he had a similar incident in the future and it would be registered as a prior.
Right.
That's the only reason in the future people would care about this original one would be... something else happens.
Right, but here's the thing.
He crashes his car head on into somebody's car.
Right.
That would be road rage.
Oh, definitely.
You know,
yeah.
They'll go back to this of, while he did that. Oh, look, he, you know, crashed in this person's car. And, oh, they had a kid in it, too, and that.
Right.
Then they'll go and it'll be linked.
Right. Now, the thing that I don't get is that you had said, you know, this was a whole PR style, you know, him going to ESPN and asking... Or ESPN going to him and asking for an interview. Or was it him? No, it was him going to ESPN to ask for an interview. And then they ended up having actually a woman interview him. I don't know if you... Do you watch ESPN at all? Just out of curiosity. Okay. Well, you know, ESPN, they have got a lot of anchors. And one of them is Lisa Salters, who's actually a woman. And she interviewed Kareem Hunt, I believe, at his family home. And basically, she asked all these questions. You know, the video says it all. You know, what can you... You know, and he says, oh, I know right from wrong, you know... I was taught better than that. You know, I was raised by my mother and grandmother. You know, I was taught right from wrong and this and that. To be honest with you, I don't believe him one bit. I mean, it crosses your mind, like, this guy knew right from wrong, and but yet he hit a woman. And he ended up kicking her as well, on top of it. In my opinion, if he would just hit the woman, I'm like, okay, that's nothing. That is something. Don't get me wrong. That is something. You know, hitting a woman, that is meaningful. That is, you know, disrespectful to women. But then to kick her as she's on the ground defenseless trying to regather herself, it doesn't... I mean, do you see the same thing? Like, you know, that whole extra... The extra thing that he did was completely out of line.
The extra kick once she was down, mm-hmm. definitely not a good light to shine on his career.
Right.
Or any sort of person. But to be honest, a lot of women specifically... I've been wanting, equality, and that means if you want to be treated like a man and you insult a man, you're probably going to get punched.
Right, but it's like the men need to know you respect women, you don't hit them, you say, you know what, you walk away from it. I mean, heck, his friends were trying to get the woman to get out of the situation and, you know, leave that area so he could, you know, calm down. And I believe she was just so, she had all that... rage, like, hey, you know.
But if he was in control of himself, that he could have went into the room, shut the door. She sat there and pound on it, whoop-de-doo.
But then there's a point where that's a little bit excessive.
That's why they make these little things. Well, compared to...
Ooh, he just dropped it.
It doesn't matter. But
nice case, by the way.
Thank you. Yeah, they make these things, or
right.
they have those other ones that you pick up in the... depending hotel rooms.
Right.
You know, you pick up in that front desk or 911.
Right. Good point. But the thing is that, you know, his cool, I mean, he lost his cool, period. I mean, you know, you look at Ray Rice. I don't know if you did you ever hear about the whole Ray Rice thing with him and his fiance, how he got into an altercation with her, and it was a whole, was it the elevator incident, Jeremiah? Is that correct?
I didn't really watch it like that. I never really watched it until you brought it up.
Okay. Well, the Ray Rice thing was he got into an argument with his fiance, and it was graphic and clear. It wasn't like that where you couldn't really see the action. With the Ray Rice situation, you actually see him punching his now ex-wife in the face and taking her into an elevator and just, you know, laying out on her, if you know what I mean by that. Like, you know, just laying
her out.
Laying her out, punch after punch after punch. And he ended up getting, what was this? I mean, he's not even in the league anymore, if I'm not mistaken.
No, he's not.
But it just begs the question, why are these women? I mean, I get women want to be tough. I get that. Don't get me wrong. Women, you know, you want to do everything men can do. But the one thing you can't do as a woman, I get it. There's MMA fighters all over the world who, you know, fight and they do it for a sport. But it just doesn't make it right to do it out in public. If it's woman versus woman, fine. But you can't try to instigate a fight with a man. Because you know, for one thing, either you're going to get punched, as you said, or there's going to be consequences for those actions. But you can't expect to not have a man punch you if you're going to insult them with words that are very offensive to them. I mean, it doesn't... I get it. You know, you have to respect women. Don't get me wrong. I respect women wholeheartedly. I mean, believe me, I would never lay a hand on a woman, ever. But when you're 23 years old, and oh, yeah, you learned right from wrong, this and that, and then you go and pull a stunt like that, you don't do that. It doesn't make it right. I mean, do you get what I'm saying by that? Like, it doesn't make it right.
Well, unfortunately, no matter if you are taught right or wrong, you eventually, at a point, the human psyche will swap into pretty much, well, a lot of people just call it a rage mode. At some point, your brain will shut off when you get angry enough.
True. But I mean, there's to a point where you need to be able to control yourself. Like, if you're out with someone and they say something rude to you, like, in a joking matter, but you take it seriously, you need to think, okay, is this person making it seriously, or are they just making it a joke? Now, what she said, I'm not going to say the word that she said because it would be offensive on air.
Well, we don't know that for 100% of what she said.
You already told us the one word she said was a five-letter word, and you...
No, that's what he said.
Oh, that's what he... Okay, so he
I can see him, through the back of her head.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
True.
But no, what he's saying, I can't read that one.
Rich, you could see what he said. He said a word that is very offensive to women, period. And, yeah. I mean, it's... Jeremiah, you basically...
See, it's a two-way street. Takes two to tango.
Right. But if anybody who's the last person to throw a punch always gets caught. Kareem Hunt, in this sense...
Yeah, like him.
She was defenseless. She had no reason to even... I mean,
well,
she,
not including he probably benches what? Probably at least 500, whatever. That
she wasn't defenseless.
She could have benched squat, not even close to that.
It doesn't matter how much you can bench in a fight. It also doesn't matter if she looked defenseless or not. In that situation, she had all of his friends trying to keep the fight broken up.
Right.
At that point,
mm-hmm.
if she really wanted to, she had the advantage there.
In what way? In what respect?
They were all focusing on him. No attention was given to her.
Which is wrong.
At that point,
mm-hmm.
and as someone who is not a woman,
okay.
I'm only going off basic assumptions and, well... what my mother has told me.
Okay.
Most single women tend to carry self-defense tools, such as a taser or pepper spray with them.
Yeah,
but it didn't seem like she had those tools or anything. I mean, in my opinion, if she had those tools, she would have used them. My God, she would have used them.
The only really thing that we could tell, the heel... those could be used.
Oh, those things.
Oh,
You kick someone in the shin with one of those things, you're done. I mean, you're...
Well, no. Even if you go use that, go towards the face and that with a pointy heel.
Ooh.
Depending on the type of heel, there's been many cases where a stiletto has been used as a proper murder weapon.
Yeah.
Well, that I've never heard. That's the first time I've ever heard about that. Wow. Okay. Hey, you learn something new every day here on these sports shows. So, learning something new every day. So, but yeah, I mean, it's she had multiple chances to defend herself and very simply got out of that situation. I mean, you could see. I mean, you even made a good point. Kareem Hunt was not happy. I mean, he was like he had blown his top. He was like the heat miser. Speaking of Christmas, he was like the heat miser. I mean, not to make it not to make it seem like a humorous thing, but I mean, you get what I'm saying, right? The whole heat miser comparison.
Yeah, he definitely blew his top, but I think that's what she was aiming for.
Right, she was a bully. She was being a classic high school bully. I mean, simple as that.
Or she could have just been simply resentful, hoping that he'd get caught.
But then why wouldn't she cooperate with the police? Jeremiah, I don't know if you filled him in on that. That none of the people who he got into these altercations with ever cooperated with police.
Well, they did to a point until they backed out. Except the third one.
The
nightclub one, the guy that got beat up.
Right.
Then her.
And
they both backed out.
For probably money reasons. They were probably getting payouts from him to keep it quiet.
It's a good possibility.
Can you pull up his contract or his salary? I don't even know his salary right now, personally. Because I bet you there.
Oh, he's probably dipped majorly.
I mean,
he's making more than both of us.
He's probably making at least 2.5
really
mil.
Really, all of us right here.
I'd say 2.5 mil. That's my guess.
Well, it'd be kind of hard to earn less than me right now.
So.
Good point. That's good. That's pretty good.
Let's see.
So what's his salary? Let's see it.
Before he got capped. fired, capped, whatever.
Yeah, you love using that word, capped. That's awesome. Let's see. Well, what was his salary?
Let's see, career.
Oh, man, he's got to be at least up in the high millions, like 7 point something million.
1.7-ish.
1.7 mil.
Yeah.
Wow. Wow, and I bet you he was probably giving them at least $9,000 to keep it quiet.
Yeah, money talks.
Money talks. But hey, actions speak louder than words. Simple
just
as that.
This year he made, well, this is probably suffers because they let him go, but
right.
About 440.
Mil?
No, 1,000. 100,000.
440,000?
Yeah.
That's it?
100,000. 100,000.
Wow.
440,000.
Wow. Wow.
In just 2018, he got 1.2 about last year.
Wow.
So he did go. And
so he's probably giving them about nine grand just to keep it quiet. I bet you he was giving them at least $9,000. I mean, wouldn't you agree? I mean, with that kind of money that he's got to be giving them $9,000 at least to keep it quiet.
Well, it depends on if he wants any rainy day money left over.
Yeah.
But think about it. All that money's going to be going towards court funds.
Exactly.
Medical bills.
Why do you think I said if you wanted to have any rainy day funds left over?
Ah, wow, you make a good point. Wow.
No, and God knows he probably bought his mom a house and that himself a house. He probably has some other random thing. He probably has two cars.
Right. He ain't living the life of Floyd Mayweather, I'll tell you that.
You know.
He could be. If he kept his cool, he could have been living the life like that, but, you know.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, one mistake could screw you up.
Just like him, he was what?
Who, Mayweather?
So after 2019, he would have been up for a new contract.
Wow, he would have been getting...
He had a three-year deal.
Wow, wait a minute, wow.
But the funny thing is, after they let him go, Kansas City owes him...
Yes?
$380,000? Yeah. Next year.
So even though he's not playing for the team, they still owe him. He's still on their contract.
He's
going to
get $3,090 from them. Or $390,000.
Jeez.
Next year.
So even though he's
he's going to make $2 million from Kansas City.
By not even setting foot on the field for the next half of the year.
In the 3 years.
Jeez. But hey, you made a good point. Actually,
it makes a hell of a lot more money than all of us.
Money speaks louder. Money does definitely speak.
So yeah, even though he's canned, I think he can live with, you know.
Now, do you see him? I mean, Steve made a good point on the Scott and Steve show on Wednesday that he may be playing back in the NFL. Do you see?
It's Steve.
My bad.
No, Scott.
Scott. What? Gotta get those names mixed up. I mean, do you see him playing again in the NFL? I mean, do you see him ever setting foot on an NFL, on a football field ever again? Given all the repercussions he's done, you know. Yeah, he's going for counseling and all that. That just came
definitely
out. You see him being back on the field next year or in 2 years.
I'd be impressed to say in half a year.
I mean, I personally could never see Roger
Goodell. At the latest
a half a year.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but I disagree with you, because if you think about it, those actions that he took, that video says, as he put it, that video says it all about what he did. And you know what? Yeah, he apologized. Yeah, he's done everything, but you know what? He's going for counseling, but as, you know, Jeremiah made a good point, you know, when was it? Like, during the show, he said it's all a PR stunt, and I completely agree with him. Because you think about it, he had a woman interview him for an interview. He had, you know, he had all this come out. He kept it quiet for, what was it, Jeremiah, 10 months? Is that right?
About
10 months. And then he had all these other three situations. So you're saying he'd be back in the NFL in half a year? I don't see that at all. I see his career being over. I see him being out of the league, no more, nothing. I see him going and getting another job elsewhere. Because if an NFL team goes and signs him, they're plain stupid. Because, as Jeremiah put it, there could be other situations out there.
It all depends on how good of a player he is.
He's an MVP caliber player. But think about it. You were the face of the franchise in Kansas City. He was one of the faces of the franchise. He had the image of the franchise on his back. And he goes and pulls a stunt like that. He's not going to go and play for another team, because another team's going to look at that and be like, well, if there's other situations coming out, like, who knows? As Jeremiah put it, there could be more situations. We could be talking about 5 or 6 situations where he's been involved with domestic violence or violence in general.
That's why I'm saying half a year.
I see him being done, because you can't have a guy playing in the NFL who's gone through domestic violence issues. Yeah, he's going to be going through counseling. Yeah, he's going through all that.
Well, you can go through in Baltimore. Look at
Yeah, Ray Rice. Ray. He's nowhere.
No, the linebacker.
Ray.
Ray.
Who? What?
The linebacker.
Ray Lewis?
Yeah,
what
Lewis.
What did he do? I don't remember what he did. I don't remember.
Possible murder.
What? I thought that was Aaron Hernandez.
And this is what I was talking about before. Sports, well, not sports, specifically football members who have committed crimes like this, where people have not died, haven't really been permanently injured or scarred.
Right.
They tend to get off scot-free pretty quickly. It doesn't really matter in the long run. PR stunt is there for a reason. It's supposed to appeal to the people.
True.
They pay thousands for those PR people to get that word out there and make people believe it.
Not only their managers that collect a good chunk of money. Because God knows Kareem has some kind of manager of some sort.
Oh, for sure. He's definitely got an agent who's got connections all over. I mean, but you think about it, Ray Lewis, he was with ESPN for a while as with Monday Night Countdown. Now he's gone. Like, he's not even on that staff anymore. And when did this whole thing come out? Because I did not hear about him possibly committing
like
murder.
Years.
Years?
Years ago.
I'll say the last murder thing I heard about.
That was before he got retired.
The last murder I heard about, as far as an NFL player is concerned, was Aaron Hernandez with the other guy with, oh my God, what's the guy's name? Can't think of the guy's name now. But do you remember that situation? Do you remember hearing about that? Aaron Hernandez played for the Patriots, was a very good tight end, ended up being in someone's house and murdered the guy with a weapon, with a gun, and this and that. It was all
I believe
it.
It was attempted murder, if we're going off of what your friend said.
Was it? Do you remember? Was it?
I think it was attempted murder.
What, the Aaron Hernandez thing? No, I believe that was clear cut murder. Because I believe he killed himself now. Now that I think about it.
Police obstruction of justice in connection to Stabbing deaths of two men in 2000.
Bingo.
That Ray was Lewis.
Oh, Ray Lewis. I thought it was about Aaron Hernandez.
Yeah, that's right. I forgot because it happened around the Super Bowl for Baltimore.
What, the Ray Lewis? The Ray Lewis situation? Honestly, I didn't remember. That was not all over ESPN. I did not hear about that.
Yeah, right here. Lewis and two other men were charged with murder and deaths.
And is he in prison right now? I don't even know.
He had pled guilty for obstruction of justice. Wow. And yeah.
Wow, that blows my mind now. Wow. Man,
I am
slow.
Murder charges were dropped. He was sentenced to a year of probation. He's following defendants to.
Man, I am slow right now. Man, I did not even hear about that.
No way. He's following defendants. Were tried and acquitted. So they weren't charged.
Who?
Just Lewis.
Oh, just Lewis was charged? So he must have been. Okay. But his friends were not charged. They were acquitted for it?
Yep.
That's unbelievable. Wow.
Yeah, double murder. That's right.
Now, wait. Look up the Aaron Hernandez situation, because I know for a fact that he
was. That's right. It was right after the Super Bowl and that the two men died right after. That's right.
Oh, yeah. Yes. I do remember that now. Now that you say it was after the Super Bowl, I do remember that because it was all over ESPN. It was all over the networks. I mean, any channel you turned on, they were talking about that situation where two men were killed.
Yeah, back in 2000.
Bingo. I do remember. After which Super Bowl?
So, yeah.
Wait. Which Super Bowl was it after? That's what I'm trying to remember. Was it after the one against the 49ers?
No. When they made it to the Super Bowl.
The Ravens.
The Ravens.
Yeah, the Ravens were in the Super Bowl against the 49ers. When they was at Mercedes-Benz Super at the Superdome.
I remember who they played.
Okay.
Against in that.
Okay.
So, yeah, there you go. But he still played and made his money in that, but.
Yeah, but here's.
Not including Baltimore, so it just takes anybody in.
Right. I mean, heck, they had Ray Rice there, and what did he do? He did something bad, and you know what? He was out of the league in no time.
Well, no, Baltimore, they have quite a screwed up.
Like who?
Bunch of people.
Like who?
Well, people getting in trouble, you know, drugs, all that stuff.
Oh,
it's sort of been a thing.
Right. I mean,
so.
But hey, it's not as. I mean, the Browns, they've had their share of situations. Speaking of the Browns, they've had their share. Johnny Manziel, Josh Gordon. I'll say, did you listen to any, like, were you listening to any of that Christmas music we were playing? Did you hear, you were listening to that?
Nope. I didn't even realize that Lakeland had a radio station up to now.
Seriously? Nice. What?
It sort of happens.
Yeah. I'll say, Jeremiah, why don't you pull up.
I know those LED lights. They should turn them brighter.
I'll say, Jeremiah, since we're getting.
So the police officer kept yelling at me of here at night and that when they're going around that they can see it out there at that road.
Eh. Being able to see stuff is not a. I don't think. Turning on a light too bright indoors is illegal, unless it obscures vision.
I'll say, Jeremiah, since we're getting close to the end of the show, play him one of the very angry, very angry Browns fan Christmas. I want you to hear this. This is so funny. Are you a Browns fan?
Okay. Yeah.
Eh.
Somewhat. No. Yes.
See, he's not a Bakers fan.
A what? A Bakers fan?
Yeah.
I'm okay, fine.
You're really biased towards him.
Okay.
It's near the the call of disgusting.
Wow. Wow.
See.
Well, it's true. It's really you're that biased.
True.
The somewhat ironic thing is, I'm not much of a fan of most traditional sports.
Okay.
That's why haven't really kept up on most of the things that you've asked me about.
Oh, okay. But hey, that's me. I'll talk sports 24/7 if I can. If I can, that's me.
It's true.
See, I go for some of the more unconventional sports that people don't actually think of as sports.
Like what? Soccer?
Chess. Chess is actually a sport that has a tournament.
You know about the chessboard over there, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
In fact, in my seventh grade middle school year was able to lead a first year organized chess team to claim second place in a tournament, and the first place team couldn't make it for their match against a grandmaster.
Huh. Let's say, Jeremiah, you play those the clapping or the audience clapping. Yeah, that deserves that. That deserves that for sure. Wow, that's pretty cool. I've never really been into chess personally. I've been more of the conventional sports, you know, football, basketball, baseball.
See, a lot of people are because it's more flashy. It can be easily televised.
Bingo.
How are you supposed to get someone interested in a board with moving wooden or stone pieces?
That's more for the, I don't want to be rude to anybody, but that's more for the older folks, if you will. Not to be rude or mean or anything like that.
As someone who picked up the sport at around the age of 8 and beat my grandfather.
Oh, wow. Okay, that I didn't know about. My bad. I did not mean to offend you on that. That's my fault.
I've been playing for a while.
Okay.
Here you go, Ryan.
Wow.
No, I gotcha.
Wow, Jeremiah.
You just ask, it shall happen.
Yeah, so yeah, he's got all kinds of sound effects. You name it, he's got it. I mean, it's funny.
I get bored.
Oh, boo-hoo! Let me play a sad song for you on the world's smallest violin. This is serious. I know. This really is the world's smallest violin. See?
I get bored.
Okay, play some more, Jeremiah. Come on. It's almost the end of the show. Play.
What?
Play one more. Play one more funny one. Come on.
One more?
Yeah, one more. One more. Come on. Come on. Give us the funniest one you could find.
What do you got over there?
Kevin, I was your biggest fan.
So were they.
Hey, look, everybody! Kevin's back! Kevin! We love you, Kevin! Kevin Sleeve!
Wow, okay, that one I don't remember.
Feeling it now, Mr. Krabs?
I'm feeling a warm spot.
Sorry.
Are you feeling it now, Mr. Krabs? Are you feeling it?
I'm feeling it, SpongeBob.
Patrick, that's not a ride.
Get off of me!
Are you feeling it now, Mr. Krabs? Are you feeling it now, Mr. Krabs? Art thou feeling it now, Mr. Krabs? You feeling it now, Mr. Krabs?
Oh, my God.
How about now? Can you feel it, Mr. Krabs?
Wow, that was weird. I'll say, while we close the show, I mean, I know it's getting close to that 7 o'clock hour. Play one of those videos of the Angry Browns fan. Come on, we gotta play that. Come on,
all right.
It's Christmas time. We gotta play it.
Just in time for the holidays, our present to you is a very angry Browns fan Christmas. Is 2015 over yet? Take a listen.
He's on a short leash. He's only won twice. He's gonna get canned. His head's in a vice. Patton says to play like a Brown. Patton says to play like a Brown.
What the f*** does that mean?
Another Brown season is over. To a December move any slower. New Jersey's of orange, but crappy team, it's still the same, dear. Will the someone please shoot me?
Cleveland Browns suck.
What's this? The Browns are DOA. What's this? Ray Farmer's really cray. What's this? I can't believe my eyes. It's just a nightmare. Wake up, Browns. What foul play? What's this?
There's players sitting out games, they're as healthy as can be. 9 million for a boy, how many catches? Yeah, just 3. It's crap at every home game, oh, who hired all these guys? And in my soul, I feel the loss. I now feel dead inside.
The good they told me, but they're all bums. Our new draft pick's good, but he's a bum. Our owner's rich for sure, but he's still a bum. They're all bums, bum, 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 bums. How about a good QB next season? Perhaps we'll see the return to glory. See the day when the team can win 8. How about baby steps back to earth? They're all bums.
It's Christmas time in CLE. Johnny's in the club drinking bubbly. Coaches in hot seat, stadium's empty. And Gordon's still out, he's smoking green. Jimmy, open your eyes, I'll bring winners here. I wanna say this is Cleveland, there's always next year.
Let's celebrate.